Barbie.
Hi, Ken.
Hi, Barbie.
Hi, Barbie.
Hi, Barbie.
Hi, Ken.
Hi, Ken.
Can we offer you a pair of Barbie sunglasses?
Thank you so much. Should I wear these?
Perhaps yes. A Barbie bevy.
Yes. Can I offer you a picture of my husband, also named Ken?
I was hoping you would.
Come on.
Whoa.
He's such a Ken.
The Kenergy is strong with this one.
So my first question, for people who actually have a Ken in their lives, what's your best advice?
Congratulations. And everyone should have a Ken. Because Ken exists to just, you know, be witness to the awesomeness that is Barbie.
That's right.
Is that how your Ken is? Does he have strong Kenergy?
Oh, beyond. The only thing different is he spells his name with two N's.
Ooh.
Oh,
like an extra Ken.
That's the most Ken thing I've ever heard, actually.
I totally agree.
It's two N's?
Ken with two N's.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
If there's a sequel, can I steal that?
100%, yes.
Can I be in the sequel?
Yeah.
So cool.
If you could make a movie, though, based on what you did play with growing up, what would it be about and who would star in that?
Oh, wow. As a kid, we would make cubbies all the time. And I think in America, you call that forts, like making forts. So I don't know how that translates.
Is a cubby different from a fort?
Well, we just call them cubbies. But what is a fort to you? What does that mean? Because that to me sounds like we're
safe in whatever living room battle you're engaged in.
But does it have like a roof and walls and stuff, or is it just kind of like a barrier?
A lot of times it's just
sheet and pillows.
Oh, yeah. Like sheets and this, like make like tent sort of things, but everywhere. And they were pretty extravagant.
I'm not sold on the film, but who would you cast in it?
In Cubbies 1. Fort part 1. Fortnite. Well, Ryan, obviously, because the man can do everything.
I'm going to kill it in
he
Cubby.
Can do
Cubby 1. Cubby's I can't believe
one.
It.
Cubby 1. And
I'm gonna
2.
I'm going to come at that thing so hard. You're not going to know what you're doing.
Giant inflatable lobster.
Excellent.
Willem Dafoe.
Oh, perfect.
Wow.
As me. And I'll play the lobster.
Remember the inflatable chairs that you would buy at like Walmart, you know, that you would have in your bedroom as a kid? Those are a big memory for me. I would make a movie about one of those.
My favorite toy was like a phone, a large phone that you could press, and it was like family members on it. So, and I turned it into a restaurant business, but it didn't really like correlate. So like you'd press the dad and it'd be like, hello, this is daddy. What are you doing? And I'd be like, what would you like to order? But it was the best toy I ever had. It just...
Who's starring in the film?
That's pretty cool.
Richard Dreyfuss. It kind of looked like him, little button of the dad.
I'm still impressed with Issa's entrepreneurship.
That's incredible.
At such a young age.
Yeah.
Amazing.
What was the restaurant called?
Hamburgers Everywhere. Really, it was a pleasant memory.
What did I play with that? I mean, a lot of like, I mean, I rode my, like, we rode our bikes around the neighborhood and, like, literally played in the sewer. Like, you know, for fun, we did the things we weren't supposed to do.
What would your movie be about, based on what you did as a kid?
Yeah, what'd you play with as a kid?
I worked as a kid.
Oh, jeez.
I did, too, actually.
So, what's that?
I did. Yeah,
what
I did
was your job?
I had, like, every job under the sun, but the hustle started young for me. I started off by stealing my brother's toys and then selling them on the street.
That's genius.
And just marking up the price so much. And then he'd be upset, obviously. His toys are all gone, but I didn't give him any of the money either.
What would you get for, like, what kind of toy?
I'd get, like, his whole bag of, like, Hot Wheels cars and stuff like that.
What would a couple dollars? Go for? A couple dollars?
Yeah, like, I made $3 once on a bag of his cars.
And would you spend it immediately so that no one could?
No, I was pretty frugal. I stretched that dollar.
You basically started eBay is what you're saying.
Probably why.
That's when you started your production company with
exactly,
that money.
Exactly.
The Hot Wheels money.
But no, then I started working in a restaurant when I was, like, 10.
Is that legal?
No.
Okay.
I want to ask you, one of my favorite scenes when you get to the real world and you realize, oh, guys kind of rule this place, and you're starting to mimic some of the things that you see that masculine guys do. So for each of you, what is something maybe a trait or a habit that you have that you actually did take from maybe somebody that you admired or watching somebody and now you incorporate it into how you do your thing?
Oh, wow.
You are better at this than I am.
Yes. No, I'm not.
Acting-wise
or life-wise?
Either one.
Oh, my uncle was an Elvis impersonator. And I feel like on some level, it's probably what I'm still doing.
I don't have an answer to that. That's so good. Weirdly enough, I've been trying to replicate Ryan's uncle, but
yeah.
it's kind of crazy how that turned out. We
ended up doing the same.
Will his uncle be in Cubby's one?
He absolutely. Okay. If I can get him, jeez.
Hello? Hmm? Humans, we're fine.
And Ellen. Mm.
Come into my weird house, hi.
You play weird Barbie, and honestly, I feel like the word weird is a compliment. So I'm curious, what is the weirdest thing about you?
I can't say that on camera.
What would your friends say is the strangest thing?
My personality,
the things I say and do, the things that are important to me, and my goals, my past. I've always thought or known I'm weird. I know, and it's cool.
Yeah.
And I feel like I wanted to represent and champion weirdness world. In younger people, and I hope that life. Weird Barbie will serve as a shining beacon to all of them.
Hi, Barbie.
Oh, hi, Alan.
Alan is a little off, too, but in a great way.
Yeah, Alan's sort of lost.
Yeah.
He's just really unruddered, rudderless soul.
How about you?
Me, the way I live my life is weird.
But in a good way, right? I really do feel like it's a compliment to you.
I think so, too. Well, all my best friends are people I would say are weird.
How come you're so amazing?
No comment!
Issa, how about you? Anything weird?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I relate to them. Yesterday, I thought about a situation that I made up in my head, and then I got upset about it. That was weird to me. I had to pull back to be like, why did I rob myself of
it's not real.
It's not gonna happen. So things like that make me a strange person.
But you caught it.
I did catch it.
That's
so
the important thing.
I always catch it.
Flat feet!
The scene where they see the flat feet and they're like, what generates that kind of reaction in you? Just something you're like,
I have a real phobia of, like, I don't even like saying the word, but I have a real phobia of, like, rodents, of, like, rats. And I live in New York City, so that's a bad mix.
You know where that stems from? Your days playing in the sewer, is my guess.
Oh, my gosh! You brought it around!
I'm no therapist, but I'm just saying, that's kind of the obvious link to me.
Oh, my God,
no,
I really
teasing.
Got something out of that.
Yeah, okay, good,
you.
So did I.
No, I won't let you do just one appendectomy.
But I'm a man.
But not a doctor.
Can I talk to a doctor?
You are talking to a doctor.
I need a clicky pen?
No.
A sharp thing?
No.
There he is. Doctor!
Somebody get security.
Is Bobby if you still in doubt?